I guys want to go over a video here on how to solve exponential equations using logarithms. Okay, so we've already talked about how to solve equations that looks like this, where we can make it have the same base, right? 2 is going to be our base here. 2 to the 3x equals, and you can make 8, 2 to the third, right? 2 to the third power is 8. However, I also need that 5 up there. So now you could solve that, set 3x equal to 15. Since your bases are the same, those would cancel. And then 3x equals 15, x would equal 5. Okay, so today what we're going to do is we're going to solve by taking a logarithm of each side. So in this one, we have an exponential equation. We can make that, turn it back into a log, right, by using the base of 2, saying this is log base 2 of 5 that equals x. And then when you have log base 2 of 5, you can use the change of base formula, which is just log of 5 over log of 2. And then whatever that equals is going to be x. So if we type that in the calculator, log of 5 divided by log of 2 is 2.322. If we round, let's round to 3 decimal places today, 2.322. Okay, here's another one, number 2. This one says, scroll down a little bit, says 4e to the negative 0.3x minus 7 equals 13. Okay, so to solve for this one, first off, let's try to get just the e to the negative 0.3x by itself. So I'm going to add 7 to both sides and then divide by 4. If I add 7 to both sides, that's 20. So now it's 4e to the negative 0.3x equals 20. Divide both sides by 4. Okay, so now I have the e to the negative 0.3x by itself. Over here, 20 divided by 4, that's 5. All right. And then what I'm going to do is, since it's e, I'm going to take the natural log of both sides. Switch colors, maybe. Natural log, natural log. What that's going to do is the natural log and the e are going to cancel. Remember, that's a special property with the e. And that leaves us with negative 0.3x equals the natural log of 5. I'm going to keep that as the natural log of 5 for now. Because to get the x by itself, just divide by negative 0.3x on both sides. Okay. Divide by x. Just negative 0.3. I'm sorry. And that gives us the x by itself. Goodness, it's early. And then that's going to be natural log of 5. I'll type this in my calculator. Divided by negative 0.3. Again, rounded to 3 decimal places. Negative 5.365 is x. Okay, so the answers today aren't going to look too pretty, but we are able to find them using these logarithms. All right, let's try example 3. Again, solve by taking a logarithm of each side. So this time, instead of rewriting it using the change of base formula, we're just going to take log of each side here. So I'm going to put log of this side, log of this side. And what that's going to do for me if I rewrite this is now I have log of 5 to the x minus 2 equals log of 3 to the 3x plus 2. Okay. And we have that property that says I can take my exponents and put them out front of the logs. Okay, that's going to be nice. So now I have x minus 2, I even put that in parentheses, times log of 5 equals 3x plus 2 times log of 3. Okay, so this is helpful because I can get my logs on the same side of the equal sign. Let's maybe divide by log of 5 here and here. My log of 5, log of 5. So my log of 5s will cancel. And I just have x minus 2 on the left side. On the right side, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take log of 3 divided by log of 5. And then I'll have to distribute that into the 3x plus 2 since it's being multiplied currently. So I'm doing, in my calculator, log of 3 divided by log of 5. Okay, and this gives me, so equals, it's still 3x plus 2, but now that log of 3 divided by log of 5 is 0.68. And for this one, since we're not done with the problem yet, let's do a few more decimal places. So it's point, let me do 0.06826. Okay. And I'm going to distribute this in now to the 3x plus 2. So it's going to look a little bit ugly because it's this big decimal, but you should be able to handle it, I think. So in the calculator, you still have that same number in there. I'm just going to take that times 3 right now, which is 2.0478. Okay. I'm going to also take that 0.06826 number times 2 in the calculator. And so this one had an x with it. This one plus 1.3652. All right. And then what we're going to do is we're going to just solve this like a normal algebra problem. It's just really messy looking. Okay, so I'm going to, maybe I'll move my x over to this side, and I'll subtract this 1.3652 number to this side, minus 1.3652. The x's will cancel, this will cancel. Negative 2 minus 1.3625 is going to be negative 3. Minus or negative 3.3652. Okay, and then over here, if this is 2.0478x and I subtract an x, that's now just going to be 1.0478x. Okay, and I have to divide by this 1.0478 on both sides, divide by 1.0478, and divide by 1, I'm doing it in my calculator, 0.478, and this should give me negative 3.2117. Negative 3.2117, if you went around, I guess, to three decimal places, negative 3.212 is x. So again, a little bit ugly, but I think you get the idea. All right, let's move on. Number 4. Number 4, this is log of 7. Log base 7 of 3x minus 2 equals 2. For this one, we can rewrite this as an exponential equation. So just like our first one, we change it from exponential to a log. This one you can go backwards, especially if they give you a base here. If they give you a base, the way you can do this is, remember, the base of your log is the same as the base of your exponent. It's just these two parts are switching. So now it's 7 squared equals 3x minus 2. All right, 7 squared is 49 equals 3x minus 2. And then you just solve this like an algebra 1 problem. Add 2 on both sides. 51 equals 3x. Divide by 3. And 17 equals x. All right, what about in number 5? Number 5. Similar idea. However, first let's go ahead and maybe divide this by 4. So we just have the natural log of 3x plus 1. So now it's natural log 3x plus 1 equals 6. Okay, and then remember, natural log is the same. I can replace natural log with log base e. In order to write this as an exponential, you want to have a base. And you have to remember that natural log is log base e. So this is now going to become e to the 6th equals 3x plus 1. Okay, and then e to the 6th is just a number. Remember, e is a number in the calculator. You can type that in. So I'm going to do it in mine. E to the 6th power. So e to the 6th is 403.428 equals 3x plus 1. Subtract 1 on both sides. Now it's 402.428 equals 3x. And that number should be in your calculator, divided by 3. Let's see. So I guess I have to subtract 1 first on mine and then divide it by 3. And that gives me 134.143. 134.143 equals x. Okay, I think these ones are probably the easiest ones we're going to do. All right, let's try example six. This time we're going to solve by rewriting as an exponent and rounding it to three decimal places. So same idea, except with this one, let's see. This one, it's expanded a little bit, so we might need to condense it first. You'll notice here this is log base 5 of something. And so we can rewrite this as our condensed version of log base 5. And we know that we could do x plus 6 times x plus 2. Okay, equals 1. It's still all log base 5. Let's go ahead and do that math. Let's see, x, if I FOIL this, this is going to be log base 5. X times x is x squared. X times 2 is 2x. X times 6 is 6x. So that's 8x. And then 6 times 2 is 12. Okay, equals 1. And then we can go ahead and rewrite this as an exponential. So 5, the base of your log is the same as your base of your exponent, 5 to the first, or just 5, equals x squared plus 8x plus 12. Okay, and so this one, remember 5 to the first is just 5. So I can go ahead and subtract 5 to the other side, which would give me x squared plus 8x, and then 12 minus 5 is 7. Okay, and since we subtracted 5 over, this would equal 0 on the left side. I'm going to move the 0 to the right side. That's the way I like it. And then this can factor to be, what would that be, x plus 7, x plus 1. Plus 7, x plus 1 equals 0. And then solve these, so x equals negative 7 and x equals 1. However, we do have to check for extraneous solutions. And the way you do that is you go back to your original. I'll do this in a different color here. Go back to your original, and whatever this is, log base, whatever of, so in this set of parentheses here, you need to see if when you plug in your answer, is it gonna be less than zero? If it is, that's bad, and that's gonna be no solution for that part. So for example, with this negative 7, if I put in negative 7 plus 6, negative 7 plus 6, of course, is negative 1. And that's less than 0, so negative 7 will not work. Therefore, 1 would be our answer. And again, you can check that. 1 plus 6 is 7. 1 plus 2 over here is 3. It's greater than 0 for both. So this one only has an answer of 1. There's going to be a few in your assignment today where there's extraneous solutions, and you will not use those. Okay, we do have a property of logs that you have to remember. And that's just if they have the same base, log base b of x equals log base b of y, then you can almost cancel out those logs and say that x equals y. Okay, so I'll keep that uncovered so you can see it. So this first one says log base 4 of 2x plus 8 equals log base 4 of 6x minus 12. All you're going to do on this is go 2x plus 8 equals 6x minus 12, essentially canceling the log base 4, and then you can solve these. Okay, if I subtract 2x on both sides and add 12, this gives me 20 equals 4x, and so x equals 5. All right, again, fairly simple on those ones. Let's try number 8. Number 8, this is the natural log of x equals natural log of x plus 6 minus natural log of x minus 4. Again, I'm seeing that I can condense this, right? And so now I have natural log of x equals the natural log of x plus 6 over x minus 4. Again, it's divided by because of the subtraction sign. We learned that on a couple days ago, I think. Oops. So what we want to do here, since this is natural log of both of these, the natural logs will cancel, like we learned on the last slide, and we just have x equals x plus 6 over x minus 4. Let's solve this kind of like a proportion, where you can think of it as cross multiplying, or if you don't like that, you can multiply by x minus 4 on both sides. What that's going to do for me is give me x squared minus 4x equals, those cancel over here, x plus 6. If we get these all on the same side, this would now be x squared minus, let's see, 4x minus x is minus 5x. And then if I subtract the 6 over minus 6 equals 0. Again, we need to solve this by factoring. So this would be x and minus 6 and x plus 1. Okay. And with this one, let's see, if I solve the, if I remember set equal to 0, so if I solve x equals 6, x equals negative 1, let's look back at my original parts here. And if I plug in 6, let's see, 6 plus 6 is good. That's 12. 6 minus 4 is 2. That's good. The negative 1, I think, gets me into trouble right here. Negative 1 minus 4 is negative 5. So that will not work. So negative 1 is an extraneous solution. This one only has the solution of x equals 6. All right, scrolling down to number 9. Number 9, log base 12 of x minus log base 12 of x plus 2 equals log base 12 of 3. A bunch of log base 12s. So we're thinking we can maybe condense this and then cancel the log base 12s is what my game plan is. So this would now become on the left side log base 12 of x over x plus 2 equals log base 12 of 3. The log base 12s will cancel since there's log base 12 on both sides. So we have x over x plus 2 equals 3. Okay, we can, again, think of this as a, I'm going to do this one as a proportion this time. So if I cross multiply, x times 1 is x, and then 3 times x plus 2 is 3x plus 6. Right, we can, let's subtract 3x on both sides to give me negative 2x equals 6. So x equals negative 3. Again, you got to double check that the negative 3 works. But you can see when I plug it back in here, or here for that matter, that's going to be a log of a negative, and that is bad, right? Negative 3 plus 2 is negative 1. So this one, since this is the only answer and it is extraneous, this one has no solution. This is a no solution problem. All right, and I think that does it for the notes today. Your assignment is going to be page 465, numbers 6 through 10. 14, 18 through 24, 32 through 34, and 44 through 50, all evens. And I think that's about 14 or 15 problems is all. So it looks like a lot, but not too bad. All right, guys, we'll see you next time.